Suppose G has n vertices of varying degree. We can order the vertices by degree, putting them in what's called non-decreasing order because there could be equality. This produces the degree sequence of the graph. For example, suppose we want to produce the degree sequence of the graph shown. So, we see this node has degree 3. This node has degree 3. There's a 2, a 4, and 2 1s. Given a graph, we can find its degree sequence. But can we go backwards? Can we produce a graph from a given degree sequence? We say that a sequence where each term is greater than or equal to the next is graphical if a graph exists with the given degree sequence. For example, we might see if this sequence is graphical. So remember, the sequence gives us the degrees of every vertex in the graph. So if this graph exists, this would be a graph with 6 vertices. Unfortunately, there's a lot of them, and we can't just rely on a graph falling out of the sky and hitting us on the head. Actually, how about this one? And in fact, this is the graph that produced this degree sequence. But what if we hadn't already seen this graph? Could we construct a graph with a particular degree sequence? For example, how about this one? Such a graph would have to have 4 points, one of which is connected to 12 others, which is impossible. So no such graph can exist. Now, while this analysis might work for small graphs, it will be much harder if there are more vertices. And even if a graph with a given degree sequence exists, we might still not know how to connect it. So let's investigate. So first, we know that in a graph, the number of vertices with odd degree must be even. So we might take a sequence, and we can immediately decide, since there are 3 vertices of odd degree, no graph exists with this degree sequence. While the handshake theorem tells us when a graph doesn't exist, we can't use it to say whether a graph could exist. For example, this is not graphical, even though there are an even number of vertices with odd degree. To proceed, let's consider a simpler problem. By that, let's talk about a smaller graph. So suppose we remove one vertex from a graph. If the vertex has degree d, then d of the remaining vertices will have their degrees reduced by 1. Now lather, rinse, repeat. Since every removal reduces the number of terms by 1, eventually we'll either get a sequence that is obviously graphical or obviously non-graphical. So let's see if this sequence is graphical. We'll eliminate one of the degree 1 vertices. Since this vertex was connected to one other, we'll reduce another degree by 1. But which one? The problem is that when we eliminate a vertex, we can only reduce the degrees of its adjacent vertices. But we can't tell which vertices are adjacent from the degree sequence alone. So what can we do?
If you build it, they will come.
So instead of removing vertices, let's add vertices. That way we can choose which vertices increase their degree. So suppose we have a graphical sequence. If we add a vertex with degree k, then k of the terms will increase by 1. Since the degree sequence should be non-decreasing, let's assume k is greater than the first term and add 1 to the first k terms, giving us, since we began with a graphical sequence and produced a graph, the new sequence is also graphical, giving us an important result. Suppose we have a sequence that's graphical. If k is greater than the first term, then We can prepend the sequence with k and add 1 to the first k terms to get another graphical sequence. And this suggests we can reduce a sequence by starting with the largest term. So, for example, we might try our sequence again. We'll eliminate the degree 4 vertex and reduce the first 4 degrees by 1 to give us... Now keep in mind that this is a new graph, and because we want to find the degree sequence, we would put the degrees of the vertices in order. And as long as they're all there, it doesn't make a difference. So we can rearrange this degree sequence as... Next, we'll eliminate the degree 2 vertex and reduce the first 2 terms by 1, which we can rearrange as... Now, at this point, we have a graph with 4 vertices, 2 of which are isolated, and 2 of which have degree 1. Let's try to produce a graph with this degree sequence. So let's put down 4 vertices. 2 of the vertices have degree 0, so there will be no edge incident on those vertices. And 2 of the vertices have degree 1, and we can achieve that by linking them. Now, let's see if we can work our way backwards to the original graph. Remember, we obtained this sequence by reducing and rearranging. What this means is that we removed a degree 2 vertex that was linked to 2 vertices whose degrees became 1 and 0. So working backwards, we'll want to add a vertex linked to a vertex of degree 1 and a vertex of degree 0. So we'll link over to this vertex with degree 1 and up to this vertex with degree 0. Let's try to take another step back. So remember, we got this sequence by reducing, and again, we removed a vertex of degree 4 attached to vertices of degree 3, 3, 2, and 1, leaving them with degrees 2, 2, 1, and 0. So we'll add a vertex and link it to vertices of degree 2, 2, 1, and 0 to get our original degree sequence and our graph. While this algorithm terminates, it doesn't necessarily give us an answer. If the final sequence is graphical, then the original sequence is also graphical. But if the final degree sequence isn't graphical, it's conceivable that the original was graphical. And remember, as long as the process might return undecided, it can't be called an algorithm. So let's look at this further.